And I'm going to start from 13, right? Revelations 13:13. And he doth great wonders. Actually, start from 12. Actually, 11. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon, all right? So the two horns, like that beast is talking about the NATO and the EU, right? This system that we're living in right now is the beast system of the book of Revelations, all right? So it says, and I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, all right? And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon, all right? So the two horns that, what the two horns represent on his head, or the two horns like a lamb, sorry, basically represent, going back to Rome, what you know is the plebeians and the republicans, all right? Which basically today being represented by, over here in the UK, you have the conservatives, you have the Labour Party, but then also over in the land of America, you have the, what's that bloody called? The Republicans and the Democrats, all right? That's basically signed that came about in the Roman rulership, right? Prior to the Greek and Rome, the Greco-Roman Empire, every nation that ruled on the earth, they basically had kings that ruled over the earth, right? But they were the first to exercise a thing known as democracy, whereby the people vote in a man to rule for a set amount of time, and then they transition the power over to the next. That's why it mentions this in the Bible. So let me read it again. So it says, Revelations 13 and 11 says, and I beheld another beast coming out of the earth, all right? And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. So the two horns represent democracy in a nutshell. But then also it says he spake as a dragon. That's that draconian rulership, all right? Which basically is now being established, right? If a lot of people don't know, if you look up the word, I'm mispronouncing it right now, draconian rule, that's basically tells you it's the most severe form of rulership. And that's what we're basing a time of austerity right now, right? That's why you only allow X amount of people around your house. You can't do this. If you want to fly, you need that, blah, blah, blah. It's that them speaking as a dragon, right? So verse 12, it says, and he exercised all the power of the first beast before him. Right, and the power of the first beast is basically talking about the Roman rulership, the Greco-Roman rulership, which is being exercised as in this time, in this day and age today. Right, so it says, verse 12, it says, and he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them that dwell therein to worship the first beast whose deadly wound was healed. And all the people today are basically worshipping the first beast. Whether they know or they don't know, they're worshipping the first beast. Okay? For the most part, they don't know. Right? So it says, and he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. Right, and what was that fire that came down from heaven? Right, really the first time you had the fire come down, which isn't really pertaining to this prophecy, which basically set the precedent for them to establish their power, was the atomic bombs, right, that fell on Japan. Right, that was basically a way for Esau, Edom, and really the beast system to establish their power on the earth, right? That was a miracle, right? To basically make bombs fall from the heavens upon a land, that was a form of a miracle. So let me read it again. So it says, and he doth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. Right, but the actual account it's talking about is a Yugoslavia bombing by NATO in 1995, I believe. Right, if my memory serves me correct. That was the first time this beast system basically established that miracle and put everyone under manners, basically. Alright? So verse 14, it says, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth. Right? A lot, most of the people on this earth under the deception based upon that power that was established by the NATO and the EU, all right? So it says, by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, right? Okay, so it says, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound of by a sword and did live, right? So when it talks about an image, okay, the image of the beast which precedes the mark of the beast basically is a culture of the beast, more or less, right? To really go into detail, the image is something, is basically democracy, right? LGBT community having rights, right? Men and women are equal. All these different things that basically personified within this this kingdom is part of the image of the beast, right? So it says, it says verse 15, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause as many that would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Right? So basically, if you don't follow the image of the beast, ultimately what they want to do is kill you. Alright? And you could say right now the COVID-19, the vaccine, that falls in line with the image of the beast. Alright? But all the things, it's really going to come into a hole with the mark of the beast, basically. Alright? So it says, verse 16, it says, and he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, to receive a mark in their right hand, right? And that mark is talking about RFID chip, right? And this is the time that we're in right now. We're in the time of the mark of the beast, basically, which a lot of people are not aware of because they don't know what a mark of the beast is, right? Their pastors ain't told them, nor has their government told them, because guess what? Their government wants to put that mark in their flesh, right? They're not aware that this government that's in place is based on the beast system, right? So I'm going to read verse 16. It says, and he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. So yeah, before the Lord actually makes his appearance, there's going to be a time where no one's going to be able to buy or sell without the mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip, okay? And during that time, that's really going to be the hour of temptation for those of the elect, right? Because they're going to be tempted to basically take the mark to have the ability to eat and live within the society that we're in today, all right? But they're going to be, but the Lord said in that hour of temptation, that basically is going to make a way for them to be delivered, all right? So verse 18, it says, here is wisdom. Let him that have understanding count the number of the beast, for it is a number of a man. And his number is 666, all right? And that number is basically found on a barcode. When you look at any barcode, the actual numbering, you have three lines basically that are bigger than the rest on the barcode. You have the one that's on the left hand side, one in the center, and one on the right hand side. When you go into the numeric value, right, or what that number represents when you scan it, basically what you find there is a number 6, right? So when you add all those three, you have 6 on the left hand side, 6 in the middle, and 6 on the right hand side. And that basically is the number of the name which you find on the RFID chip, right? So basically, that's what it's talking about. But let me go back to Revelation. Jeremiah. So it says Jeremiah 30:7. It says, "Alas for that day." time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it, all right? Because the Lord is basically going to deliver his elect. There's and I'll read the scripture in Isaiah. Scripture that says it basically says when an enemy cometh in like a flood, then shall I raise up a standard against him. Alright? Which that standard is basically spiritual power. Okay? The Heavenly Father will deliver his elect from that said judgment. If you're of the elect, if you're not of the elect, then you're gonna be judged, man. And that's why we hope. That's why we even say we believe that we're part of the hopeful elect. Because we hope to be saved, right? And by doing his works, coming out on the highways and byways, we're basically depositing into that spiritual bank account, right? Our interest on the talent, and hoping that we can deposit it in that time of evil. So let me read this again. So Jeremiah 30:7, it says, "Alas, for that day is great, for none is like it. It's even a time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it," right? Verse 8 says, "For it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, that I will break the yoke from off thy neck, and will burst thy bonds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves upon him." Alright? And that's basically what's going to happen in this day and age we're in. Alright? You're basically going to have the yoke being broken off of us, and we're basically going to enter into the pleasure of the Heavenly Father. So it says, verse 9, "But they shall serve the Lord as their power, and David their king, whom I will raise up unto them." Right? So basically, we're going to raise up, King David. He's going to be set up as ruler over the nation of Israel, okay, in that day. I'm gonna close out on this scripture. It's a book of Sirach. Book of Sirach, second chapter and the first verse, it says, "My son, if thou come to serve the Lord, Yahweh, prepare thy soul for temptation." Right? So serving the Heavenly Father is about being tempted. Right? Through that temptation, basically what the Lord does is he's establishing faith, right? A reliance on the Heavenly Father to know that whenever your back's against the wall, you find yourself between a rock and a hard place, that basically he's going to be the one that's going to deliver you through that situation, right? Set thy heart aright, right? Set your mind right. And it says, and constantly endure, right? So it says, set your mind, when you find yourself in a being tempted of your Heavenly Father, set your mind aright, get your mind in gear, and endure, basically. The word endure means to make, means to make hard, basically, right? So it's basically the Lord tempering you, right? Like you have For example, you have these lampposts out here. What you find is the steel that's being used in them is galvanized steel. And the reason why it's galvanized is basically so it can withstand the rain, right? Because if it's galvanized, what's basically going to happen is it's going to rust and it's going to basically deteriorate and you ain't going to have no light on the streets. But it's the same with the men of the Heavenly Father. The Lord's going to galvanize them. And that's what you even find in the American Army. What they call, you have a thing, they have the GIs. G.I. Joe, for example. The word G.I., one of the meanings for it is galvanized iron, right? Because they go through their training camps where basically they get galvanized to being war ready, right? And that's the same thing the Heavenly Father's doing with his men by putting them through manifold temptations. So let me read that again. So it says, and constantly endure and make not haste in a time of trouble. So it says, when you find yourself in a troubling time, it's telling you not to basically make haste and run away, but basically constantly endure and get through it, basically, right? So verse 3, it says, cleave unto him and depart not away, that thou mayest be increased at thy last end, all right? So basically, when you're going through all these situations, you basically have to go through it, endure, and basically, if you're going through it, what you're going to find is that when you get through it, the Heavenly Father is going to exalt you at that last end, and ultimately the last end being in a time of election, all right? As it told you, as Paul spoke of it in the book of Sirach, I mean,